Good morning, everyone. I hope you're well and looking forward to today's learning. Just before I give you your new challenges for today, I've got a quick question for you. I was really impressed yesterday with your super ordering of the months of the year, and we've just gone into a new month. If I tell you that last month it was April, I wonder if you can tell me what month we're in now. So what month comes after April? Now for your learning challenges for today. Your first challenge is in two parts. The first one is phonics. I want you to find the link on your journal, read the sentence and draw a picture to match the sentence in your yellow book. Once you've finished your picture, you could upload it to us on Seesaw. The second part of your first activity is to find your reading book. You need to find the link on Seesaw and follow today's instructions. These tasks should only take you 30 minutes. The second challenge today is a math challenge, and again, it's in two parts. The first thing I would like you to do is to log on to your Doodle Maths account. You'll need a grown-up to help you do this. But once you're logged on, I want you to work independently to complete your 5-a-day challenge. Don't forget, independently means do it on your own. This should only take you about 10 minutes. Once you've completed your 5-a-day challenge, I want you to look on Seesaw and find the link to the Maths 2A on your journal and listen to the song about the seasons. I wonder, can you draw a picture of the four seasons in your book and add a title for each season? We've uploaded a picture, which is Maths 2B, to help you. We call the fall autumn when the leaves fall off the trees. You might need a little bit of help from a grown-up, but this activity should only take about 20 minutes. I hope you enjoyed going on a bear hunt of your own yesterday. But I wonder, if you were going on a bear hunt like the one in the story and you went through places like forests and rivers and snowstorms, I wonder what you'd take. I think I'd take a map so I wouldn't get lost, and maybe a drink of water so I wouldn't get thirsty. Your third challenge today is to write a list of 5 things you would take with you on your bear hunt. I would like you to take a picture of your list and upload it to Seesaw. But what all of your teachers want to see today is you using your super phonic knowledge to write your list. I wrote my list and I've been using my phonics. I've listened to the sounds I heard and then I've wrote them. I'm going to read my list to you. M-A-P, map. F-O-N, phone. W-O-T, water. Shoes, shoes, although I think they'd have to be snowshoes, and a cake. These words might not be spelled correctly, mums and dads, but I've used the phonic knowledge that your children know, so don't worry if they don't spell the words correctly. What we want the children to do is to use their own phonic knowledge and write the sounds that they hear. Don't forget, upload these lists to Seesaw for us to have a look. For your last activity today, we would like you to be creative and draw or paint a picture of a bear. I know Mrs. Jones has been having fun painting pictures of bears, and Mrs. Ford can't wait for this challenge because we all know she loves to draw and paint. You could either choose to draw your picture of your bear in your book or go onto the Sketches app on your iPad. However you decide to draw your picture of your bear, don't forget to take a photograph of it and upload it to Seesaw so we can have a look at it. I hope you enjoy today's challenges, and don't forget, upload them to Seesaw because we love seeing all of your work. Take care, everybody. Stay safe. See you soon. Bye.